Well, today the state education department released report cards for all school districts in South Carolina.
As expected, many schools did not meet academic expectations, primarily because of the pandemic. News 19's Julia Kaufman takes a closer look at school districts in the Midlands.
Schools have been fighting to make up lost time in learning due to COVID-19. Father of four, Cody Smith, says his kids struggled with virtual learning last year.
My youngest especially, I think that it was hardest for her, just to her personality and also where she is in her education, being in third grade last year.
The Richland One family did its best to stay on track.
We were able to get tutors to help us kind of stay on path where we were. We're fortunate that we could do that.
But like many, chose to opt out of end-of-year exams last spring. The state bases annual school report card ratings off those exams. That's why the newly released data comes with a disclaimer. Quote, the results displayed within this report card should not be compared to those of other years due to testing limitations as a result of the pandemic. Results may be incomplete and may not represent the makeup of the state, district, or school population. In the Midlands, according to the report, only two districts exceeded the state average in math, reading, and writing, Lexington 1 and Lexington Richland 5. All others struggled to meet or exceed grade level expectations. Orangeburg County School District tells News 19, many families in our district chose to opt out of state testing, which yielded low numbers of test takers and scores that may not reflect the content mastery of students. Richland 1 was also below the state average in all academic scores, but saw an uptick in their graduation rate.
What that says to us is the longer our students are with us, they do better, and we're able to get them to the point of graduation.
Superintendent Craig Witherspoon says the report cards give some insight on the effects of the pandemic.
It's a snapshot in a very difficult time.
Federal funding was dispersed to schools to address learning loss. Witherspoon says they've spent it on enhanced summer programs and Saturday school.
We've used some of those additional funds to support interventionists at the elementary and middle level that would work with a small group of students that are experiencing difficulty.
He says they're also investing in student emotional and mental support. In Columbia, Julia Kaufman, News 19, WLTX.